What's going on, guys? Eddie at Fliptronics. We're going to be taking a look at if the iPhone SE 2 is better than the iPhone 11. Okay, so I've had the SE 2 now for like 2 or 3 weeks. So I've had a chance to really test it out. Just want to take a closer look at how it stacks up against the iPhone 11 and if it's worth buying. So let's get into it. All right, so we've got the iPhone SE 2 and the iPhone 11 both in red. Now, both phones do have similarities, such as they both have glass designs. The screen sizes, cameras, those are going to be completely different, which I'm going to get into here. Also throw some links in both the description and comments if you want to check out the latest prices for these phones. Now, let's flip them over and get a closer look. So clearly the SE 2, much smaller screen. It's got some notches too, obviously, at the bottom and top of it. At 4.7 inches, it's going to be a lot smaller than the 6.1 inch LCD display of the iPhone 11. You know, you're also going to notice it's got the home button on the SE 2, which is kind of cool. I'm glad they brought that back. But what I want to do here is I'm going to throw up some Netflix. I'm going to do like a little bit of a sound quality test. We're going to check out the displays on both phones. So I'm going to let this run for a little bit. Then we're going to check out some gaming. I'm going to give you some of my, you know, final thoughts. Also, if you guys could smash a like button as you're watching this, I would also appreciate it. So let's get into some of the Netflix here.
What happened in that motel room?
It was coupon night and I was trampolining your wife.
You're a real comedian, aren't you, Snow?
Well, I guess that's why they call it the punchline.
You don't like me. Again. What happened in that motel room?
It was coupon night and I was trampolining your wife.
You're a real comedian, aren't you, Snow?
Well, I guess that's why they call it the punchline.
You don't like me, do you?
Don't flatter yourself. I don't like anybody.
With that attitude, I can see why you like it.
Oh, come on.
All right, so I don't know about you guys, but I definitely felt like the iPhone 11 was a lot louder than the SE 2. And then, of course, you know, looking at the screens, much more enjoyable on the iPhone 11 having that much bigger display. Now, we're going to get into some gaming here. PUBG, you know, started playing this game a lot again. I'm going to try to multitask it on both phones. We'll see what happens here. And hopefully I can get some kills on both phones. I do want to say, you know, as far as like gaming on the SE 2, I've definitely enjoyed it. The one thing about using a smaller phone that I've mentioned is that, you know, it's a lot easier to hold one-handed. It fits in your pocket a lot nicer than some of the bigger phones out right now. And then, of course, you know, kind of back to the whole point here, you know, the price point on the SE 2 at $400, it's going to be a lot more affordable than the $700 price point on the iPhone 11. Anyways, let's get some PUBG rolling here. Let's try to get some kills, multitask this game on both phones, and let's get into it.
Thank you.
right, so I was able to get some kills on both phones while playing PUBG, but clearly the better phone of the two is going to be the 11, but it does cost a little bit more. Clearly it's $700. I still like the SE2 at $400 though, so I'll have links in the description and comments if you want to check any of these out.